Hi friends, today we are going to discuss about microbeads and also microplastics. So microplastics are tiny bits of plastics which are measuring less than 5 mm in diameter. Okay, so basically microplastics are tiny bits of plastics. Okay, now you can see the classification of plastics there. Less than 5 mm we can call it as microplastics. If the plastic beads is having size between 5 to 20 mm, then we can call it as meso. Then greater than 20 mm we can call it as macro. Then greater than 100 mm we can call it as mega plastic, right? So that's a classification only. So out of this, microplastic is having some much more important because it is having more environmental impacts. Okay, so we need to discuss about microplastic. A 2017 study or report by United Nations Environment Program concluded that around 1.5 million tons of microplastics are entering ocean waters every year. Okay, so that's a study, that's a report by UNEP, right? So around 1.5 million tons of microplastics are entering ocean water every year. Okay, so we know that we have, the mankind have made lots of plastic waste, right? So all these are ultimately wind up in the oceans, and that will result into the formation of microplastics, because plastic is photodegradable. That means plastic undergo photodegradation process. When the sunlight strikes on the plastic, it will become brittle, and over time it will make into small particles. Okay, so microplastics are tiny bits of plastics measuring less than 5 mm in diameter, and we are having mainly two types of microplastics called as microbeads and microfibers. So microbeads and microfibers are the two types of microplastics. Okay, so these microbeads and microfibers are made by the humans itself in order to use in some goods and products. Okay, so like microbeads are used commonly in the cosmetics, toiletries such as the facial body scrubs or toothpaste and shower gels. And microfibers are tiny strands of fabric that break away from the clothing made from synthetic fibers when they are washed. Okay, so microbeads and microfibers are two types of microplastics which are made by humans itself. And microplastics are also made by natural means, because plastics are photodegradable. Through the photodegradation process also, microplastics are being produced. Okay, so we need to discuss more about the microbeads. Okay, so these microbeads are pieces of plastic, usually spherical in shape, that range in width from a fraction of a millimeter to about a millimeter and a quarter. Right, so they are usually spherical in size, and they are having a size of around 1 millimeter. So these microbeads are used in the soaps or body care products, because the exfoliating products need small hard particle to rub debris from the skin, right? So in order to get a rubbing action, in order to remove the debris from the skin, they require the exfoliating products like the soap require a small tiny particle which are hard enough to remove the debris from the skin. That's why microbeads are produced by humans in order to use in the soaps or exfoliating products. Okay, and it is also used in the toiletries, right, in order to get the scrubbing action. So earlier times in the soaps and all, we were using natural materials. Okay, but since 1990s, the manufacturers, they have increasingly replaced the natural materials with the microplastics. Okay, so these microbeads, they have even used in the toothpaste. So in the toothpaste, you can see some shiny materials, right? Shiny and tiny materials. So that is also a microbeads. Okay, so microbeads are even used in the toothpaste in order to get the scrubbing action, right? So the plastics used in the microbeads readily absorb the pollutants, and that's why it is widely used. It will absorb, or its surfaces in such a way that it can absorb pollutants and also other chemicals. Okay, now what is the problem regarding, or what is the impact of these microplastics or microbeads in the ecosystem or the environment? Actually, we know that it's a tiny bits of plastics particles, right? So the aquatic organisms like the zooplanktons or something like that, or the fishes, turtles, these kinds of marine organisms or the zooplanktons, they will mistake the tiny bits of plastics for their food. Okay, so thereby this marine organism or the aquatic organism, they will consume the microbeads or the tiny bits of plastics mistaken for their food, right? Thereby the microplastics along with the chemicals which they added will be passed through the food chain. So I said that microbeads are readily absorbing the pollutants as well as the chemicals, right? So when the animals consume the microplastics, along with the microplastics, some chemicals are also being consumed by the animals or the aquatic organisms. Okay, so thereby the chemical and also microplastics will be passed through the food chain, right? And it will undergo the bioaccumulation as well as the biomagnification process. So microbeads along with chemicals will undergo the biomagnification and bioaccumulation process. So these microbeads are also used in the chewing gums, certain toothpaste, industrial cleaning products, synthetic clothing fibers and tires. So these are some products which are using the microbeads, right? So ultimately these microbeads is having an impact on the ecosystem or in the food chain, or ultimately through the bioaccumulation and biomagnification process, it will even reach to the humans. So even the microplastics, I said that it is microplastic is measuring less than 5 mm in diameter, right? So even this microplastic may choke in the ducts or the throat of the aquatic organisms, like the turtles, like that. Thereby also the animals, aquatic organisms will choke to death due to the consumption of microplastics. Okay, that much impact microplastic is having on the environment, right? Now let's move on to the model question. With reference to microbeads, consider the following statements. They are tiny bits of plastic. Yes, they are tiny bits of plastic, right? So first statement is correct, then we eliminated B. Then second statement, even though it is an environmental pollutant, it doesn't affect the food chain. That's a wrong statement, right? Because microplastic along or microbeads along with its chemicals will undergo the bioaccumulation as well as biomagnification process, thereby it is impacting the food chain. So that's why second statement is wrong. So if the second statement is wrong, we eliminated D also. Now the third statement, they are found in exfoliating body washes, facial scrubs as well as in the toothpaste. So that's also a correct statement. These are the consumer products where we can see the microbeads, right? So third statement is also correct. So answer will be C, 1 and 3.